What have I learned? We gotta take this one up to a safe place and kill it. It's hard to find dry, firm ground around here, but I'm gonna try. I'm gonna just take him up there for now.
Bank over there?
I don't think he's... I didn't think the last one was getting out of the net, but let me see if I can... Look, it's trying to come up out.
He's trying to crawl right out of that.
Alright.
Alright.
Well, that's the second one on the Confidence Baits jig. And you know what? I don't think that this is... That there are such thing as a... I may be wrong, but a snakehead lure, they'll eat anything. Beetle spin, frogs, spinner baits, jigs, whatever. They just eat. He's going in the bag. This is the spot where I got the where the snakehead bit, and I was skipping all the way to the back of that, and as soon as it probably had two or three skips on the way in, and as soon as it hit right on the bank, everything under there just exploded. And I'm probably real lucky that I landed that fish. We got this big log right here sticking out, and fortunately he came up on this side instead of wrapping around it that way. But if there's a preferred habitat of a snakehead, overall, by and large, it's shallow. Anywhere shallow, and that's the shallowest area here. Ah! Oh! And the bass like it too. I missed him. He was right on that log. Another one off the wood, just dropping it down in the. That's a good one. Dropping it down in between the logs. All right. Another jig fish. Yeah, we're getting close to low tide, and the current's really ripping through here. You got a bunch of these logs that at a little bit higher tide, you couldn't see anything. You know, you might feel it if you drag the jig over it, but we can actually see it. The water's getting a little bit clearer. And as soon as it dropped down in between the two logs, he jammed it. The further we get into June, it seems like these are skinnier post-spawn fish. You can see his tail here is a little bit chewed up from the spawn. So he's just trying to recoup, and it seems like these more subtle presentations, like the jig, dropping the jig down in between the branches is working. The chatterbait, spinnerbait, those haven't been working. I've gotten two blow-ups on the frog. I think as things wear on, the frog's gonna take on more and more of a role. Traditionally for this technique, I would have used a black with red fleck tube with a rattle and an internal egg sinker rigged on a 5-aught extra wide gap hook. But I've developed this jig, the dragon jig, and I like it a lot better for the technique. I just like how it, you know, rigged with a mini packer craw, it collapses real nice. The real fine wire hook, that's a 5-aught, that just sticks right in them, the round rubber, and it just comes through the, with the head design, it comes through the wood very nicely. So it's really almost an automatic. They get it in their mouth, and as long as you have taut line, gets in them. It's gonna grab them, and you've got them. I've pulled three fish out of this area right here pretty quickly here on the Confidence Baits jig, and all I'm doing, I'm making shorter cast and letting it fall in between each of these logs. You know, I'll lift it up and watch that braided line. Lets me know when I'm right at the top of the log, and then I feed it line and let it go back in. So I'm almost like I'm punching down in between each one of these logs. Watching the line is pretty critical. Ooh, look at that snake. It's pretty critical because of you'll see your line go left or right, or you'll see it take off, letting you know there's a fish. Also it lets you know where, you know, you've reached the top of the log and you want to feed line in. He's a big friggin' snake. Pattern wrap up for the day. where I've caught most of the fish have been on the Confidence Baits jig with the Pack-a-Craw in black. And what we're doing is we're going along these on the outgoing tide, and it was also good on the income ants when we caught the snakehead. But basically, the creek channel comes around, slams into that steeper contoured bank. This bank is, for the topography of this area, is a real steep bank. Creek channel slams into it, undermines the trees that are standing there, undermine the roots, and the trees fall in. So you got a bunch of laydowns. Boom, boom, boom. Right here on the map, you can see that creek channel swinging in, banging into one shore, swinging way out, banging into another. So when you get into these tributaries of tidal waters like this, that's one real good pattern.